must be wondering, right? Why this guy is doing some dips in the middle of Museum Road? Because I'm burning calories to add more calories. I'm going to take you back in time to the 18th century, where it all started with baking in Namma Bengaluru. How the Japanese cake, the biscuits, the history of all these. I think more than talking, I'll take you to the place. Yeah, let's go.
This is the one.
Hey Priyank.
Hey Neeraj. Hey, how are you? Welcome to Bangalore Connection.
So here's Priyank with me. He owns this place, Bangalore Connection. Priyank, welcome to Bengaluru On My Plate.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Can you give us a little bit of history of this place?
Well, it was started first by my great-great-grandfather, P.V. Kupaswamy Naidu, who actually came down to Bangalore from Padavet. So he lived with his wife and his mum in a slum in Bangalore by the cantonment railway station, and baked bread in that slum and used to carry it on his head and sell it in the railway station to the passengers. So from there he grew to actually opening his own bakery in 1888.
So the bakery shut in 1982, and here you go, it's all back again, all like version 2.0. So how did his idea come to restart this whole legacy?
Well, when I moved back to London last year, I really looked around for jobs and I wanted to find something that was really interesting and fit what I really wanted to do. But then I also came back, and then I was sitting, and this one evening sitting with my grandmom and looking through albums and things like that, this one picture of my great-great-grandfather popped out, and it just, I think, was a moment of epiphany, and I said, okay, I think this is it. This is what I'm going to do, is bring it back and relive it, and that's what I'm doing now.
Let me take you through all these dishes. I think, Priyank, you will be the best one to explain. Yeah, so let's start.
So here what we do is, this is from the modern menu. Everything that you see in the showcase is from the modern age. So the first one you see is caramel with bergamot. Bergamot's an orange, and lemon curd. Then you have rose and cardamom, which is the Indian sharbat, faluda kind of flavor. Lavender, and the last one is coffee, cool coffee.
So Priyank, this place looks so beautiful, okay? The architecture is amazing. So what is the secret behind this? Did you sit with a few designers, or did you have an idea about the theme in your head?
It was basically 8 months of research with designers, but also final cuts, about a lot of rejections, and then finally reaching where we are today. But my favorite part is the facade.
It looks so beautiful, especially the logo, I must tell you.
Well, I mean, the logo of course has its own story, and of how I'm crediting my great-grandparents as well and all my ancestors in the whole story. But the circle represents basically one circle, that's the first inner circle is looking back at the past, and also the one in the outside is to the future. So, and everything within that circle. And when you look at the facade, otherwise largely we use colors of red and cream and black as well. Red because all of the old buildings in Bangalore were painted red. We're trying to spread that message, saying this is a really important building. This is a facade that you cannot miss.
Priyank, another thing I observed here was the lights.
It's the theme around baking, but they're actual cake tins that were turned into lamps.
What is this? This looks so beautiful. Of course, this is very old, I'm guessing. What is this?
Well, from what you see in that picture is this cake stand that's over 140 years old. And the story is that we're going to display it in a little more better fashion, clearly. A mirror that tells you a million stories, because every scratch on that mirror is, of course, a cake that once sat on it. The mirror's never changed. It's been polished once and so on.
And another observation is the table here. This looks very familiar to the sewing machine,
yes,
the tailoring machine.
You're very right. So that's actually what the sides are inspired from, Singer's tailoring sewing machine. So yeah, the sides are inspired by it, but everything's recreated. They're not antiques, but they're all recreated and inspired to create this table.
So welcome to Bengaluru On My Plate.
Thank you.
What's your name?
Anand.
So Mr. Anand, how long have you been in Bangalore?
I've been in Bangalore for 60 years.
Okay. How does it taste? Let me ask you your first review of this particular dish.
It's very good. And the pastry is refreshingly like the old pastry that one is used to. It's not a newfangled, it's just got the right crumble to it. So so it's a nice mixture of both the old and the new.
Perfect. So I won't stop you from having that last bit of it. Thank you so much for talking to us. So Priyank, I've come this far and I'm really hungry. Okay. See, I am on a diet, but these things are too tempting for me.
Well,
okay. I'm going to try some of these things.
Yes.
Okay. Let me see.
I think today can be your cheat day.
Yeah. Today is my cheat day. Let me try it. Okay.
Yes.
Let's go for it.
Yes.
So here you go. I've got 5 dishes in front of me. Superb. I'm telling you, the macaroons is a must try. I mean, all the dishes are a must try, but macaroons personally, for you health freaks like me, you have to try it. Oh my god, I still can feel that in my mouth. What are you guys still watching? You will need to know how all these things are made. Let's go to the kitchen.
Let's go to the kitchen.
Ta-da! So here we are at the kitchen of Bangalore Connections 1888. This is in Shivaji Nagar. This is where the previous Naidu and Sons bakery was. Priyank, let's go inside and see how the yummiest apple pies, macaroons are all made. Come, let's go. Oh my god. It smells so good. Oh yeah, let me wear it. Warm and nice. Feel the flavor in the mouth. So fresh. Sir, ek tinbit dene. I've eaten like way too much. I can't even stand, so I'm taking a support of this wall. And you guys, what you guys have to do is like, comment, share this video and let me know where I can go to figure out what I can eat in the next episode of Bengaluru On My Plate. Till then, signing off, Dheeraj, Bajate Raho. Red FM, 93.5.